बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम, अस्सलामु अलैकुम। दिस इज़ योर क्लास ऑफ पाकिस्तान स्टडीज़। वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट आवर फर्स्ट चैप्टर, हिस्ट्री ऑफ पाकिस्तान पार्ट टू। क्वेश्चन नंबर वन ऑफ दिस चैप्टर इज़ हाउ नेशनलाइजेशन ऑफ इंडस्ट्रीज मेड बाय गवर्नमेंट इन जुल्फ़िकार अली भुट्टो इरा। बिफोर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट द नेशनलाइजेशन ऑफ इंडस्ट्रीज, वी विल डिस्कस द टाइम पीरियड ऑफ जुल्फ़िकार अली भुट्टो। वी स्टार्ट फ्रॉम 20th of December 1971 टू 5th of July 1977। On 20th December 1971, he took oath as civil martial law administrator. Civil martial law administrators is a new terminology for you people. Basically, Zulfikar Ali Bhutto was a civil person and he takes government from the army. That's why we can say civil martial law administrator. On 20th of December 1971, the same date when Zulfikar Ali Bhutto takes oath, he made first speech. He said, "The country is facing serious crisis. I have taken over a time when the history of Pakistan has reached its turning point. I have to build a new and progressive Pakistan, which the Qaid-e-Azam dreamed. It is my belief that it will be definitely done. This is the time." These words were a great hope for the people of Pakistan. Main aspects of economic reforms. 1971 to 1977. Students, before going to study about the nationalization, first we will discuss about what is nationalization. Basically, there are two sectors of the economy, nationalization and privatization. Nationalization means when all the industries or financial institution are owned by the government, this is called nationalization. And privatization, when private sector or private entrepreneur run the these institution or financial institution, we can say this is privatization. Situation of economy at that time. In 1971, mostly business of Pakistan were run by the private sector. For example, 80% of our insurance business, for example financial institution, and 60% of our industrial units were run by private sector, mostly in the hands of 22 capitalistic families. Steps taken by Zulfikar Ali Bhutto. After taking oath, he takes some immediate steps to control the privatization in the country. On the 22nd of December 1971, he confiscated the passports of 22 capitalistic families. The purpose behind this confiscation is only to stop the movement of the capital from the country. The second step, on the same date, he has taken industrial license of more than ₹100 million worth issued to 19 companies were declared illegal, mean to stop them to do working. Issue of an ordinance. Main aim was to betterment of people. Zulfikar Ali Bhutto considered industrial development and stability is essential for the people of Pakistan. So he disagreed with the policies of capitalists, wealthy and industrialists. On the 2nd January 1972, he issued an ordinance. According to this issue, the 10 big industries were nationalized, and on the same date, 20 directors of different companies were changed and their managing managing agencies were closed. Industries which were nationalized. These are the 10 industries which were nationalized by an ordinance. Automobile industry, it means motor vehicle industries, cement industry, chemical industry, consumer good industry. Consumer good industry means the goods of daily use, and steel industry, petrochemical industry means fertilizers industries, social welfare industry means different social projects like schools or hospitals etc., heavy equipment industries mean where heavy equipment of different units, tractor industry, and heavy electrical equipment industry. Electrical equipment mean electrical generator or heavy equipment which is used in industries. These are the 10 industries which were nationalized in the first ordinance of Zulfikar Ali Bhutto. On 16th of January 1972, Zulfikar Ali Bhutto nationalized 11 more units. The purpose of nationalization of the government was to strengthen the economic stability and encouraged industrial development of the country. This is the question number one, in which we have studied about the nationalization of the different industries in the start of Zulfikar Ali Bhutto time period. Students learn this question carefully, especially the dates and the name of these industries. Best of luck. This is question number two, nationalization of banks and insurance companies. This is related to the previous question. In previous question, we have discussed about the nationalization of industrial units, and in this question, we will discuss about the nationalization of financial institution of the country. The 22 capitalistic families had their own banks and insurance companies, which were encouraging the capitalist system. Basically, due to this privatization, most of the wealth of the country was accumulated in few hands. To discourage this trend, Zulfikar Ali Bhutto nationalized the financial institution of the country also. On 19th of March 1972, all the insurance companies which were run under these capitalistic families were merged into one unit in State Life Insurance Corporation. And on the 1st of January 1974, he nationalized all the scheduled banks. Scheduled banks mean all the financial institutions which are working under the State Bank of Pakistan. The purpose behind nationalization of these financial institutions is to give the profit and to spend the profit on the prosperity and the betterment of the people of Pakistan. This is the question number two.
Okay student, I hope now you have better understanding of question number 1 and question number 2. This is your diary. You have to learn question number 1 and question number 2 from your notes of chapter 6, Pakistan, History of Pakistan Part 2.